Hurry and drink your coffee before it gets crazier. This is a September looks like to remember, and it starts out crazy on this September the 1st. First of all, before we could barely get past midnight, massive explosion, a third chemical plant explosion, where? In China. Also, while that was going on, we know there was a conflict taking place between the Israelis and Hamas over near Gaza. Six Palestinians are dead and rockets flying out of Gaza into Israel. While that was going on, folks, we know that the Russians have begun to move more and more troops along the eastern Ukraine border, and rioting broke out in front of the parliament in Kiev, Ukraine. But wait, are you serious? Then we got reports that the CERN has shut down. As they were running the CERN all day at very high temperatures, there was a technical problem and they had to shut it down abruptly. We're still waiting to find out what this all means here on this September the 1st. And then we find out, of course, that we've had a building collapse in Rhode Island. Six people are injured, but not life-threatening. That's the good news. But we not only you're talking about collapse, then the stock market starts to collapse. We understand that China had a big hit, losing over 4.2% of their entire value. Then the Asian markets fell. Then the European markets fell. And the stock market, the last time I checked, was down 388 points this morning in the first hour of trading. And so we begin to see, and now we have, oh, and in Kentucky, the Supreme Court has just ruled that a county clerk cannot and she must issue gay marriage licenses. Now, she's a devout Christian, and it's against her faith to issue a marriage license to people that are going to be married gay. She says, no, I can't do this. I'm a devout Christian. But isn't that strange? Because some churches are ordaining and performing gay marriages in their sanctuaries. But she is a Christian, and she really does stand on the Word of God, and her convictions are being put to the test by the highest court in the land. But wait, while all this is going on, three major hurricanes have formed in the Pacific Ocean. All three of them, Category 4. This has never happened before, and Hawaii is right in the middle of it, the state of Hawaii. All of these things happening, and it's not even 12 noon on the first day of September. Are you serious? Are you serious? Are you serious? I have to say it again, because this is a September to remember. Now, folks, we know that it's going to be Rosh Hashanah. We know the Feast of Trumpets. We know the Day of Atonement's coming. We know the Feast of Tabernacles. But we also know that CERN is going to try to hit the 99.9% speed of light on what day? On the Day of Atonement, which is also the Hajj for the Muslims in Mecca, which will also be when the Pope arrives in Washington, when is also when there is going to be the end of climate chaos and all of these things happening at the same time, a September to remember. And don't forget the sign of the blood moon, the fourth and final blood moon, a super blood moon, will be over and be visible from the entire coast, east coast of America, and the streets of Jerusalem. The Pope will visit the President, the Pope will address the Congress, and the Pope will address the United Nations and call for international law. Is something biblical going on here with the signs of the second coming of Christ? Don't miss today's live broadcast, because it's September. This might be a program to remember. 12 noon Eastern for 3 hours, from 12 noon to 3 p.m. Eastern at my website at www.paulbegleyprophecy.com. That's www.paulbegleyprophecy.com. It's time to get saved. You know, the Bible says in Jeremiah, "For the harvest is past, the summer is ended, and we are not saved." Jeremiah chapter 3, I believe it is, verse 20. The harvest is past, the summer is ended, and we are not saved.